Hello, good morning children. How are you all? You are enjoying your holidays. Okay. Stay home, stay safe. So, I am your science teacher. You can learn from home. That is why we are conducting online classes so that you can listen to these videos and you can connect to your teacher and you can feel as if you are in the classroom. So, in that way, we are also missing you. You may be missing us, isn't it? We are also missing you a lot. We are missing your cheerful smile with which you used to greet us good morning. So, in that way, you stay home, stay safe, listen to the videos and follow whatever your teacher is saying. So, I am your new teacher, science teacher, and today we'll start our lesson. Now, first of all, let me tell you, what is this season? This is summer season. Yes, very good. What season it is? Summer season. So, in this summer season, what do you get? What is the fruit, the delicious fruit you like and you get it only in this season? What is it? Yes, mango. Do you all like mangoes, children? Yes. Even I like mangoes very much. So, everyone likes mangoes, isn't it? So, to get mangoes, it's only one tree enough. So, you have to get number of trees, mango trees, isn't it? To meet the supply of mangoes. You like mangoes, your brothers, your sisters, your father, your mother, everybody likes mangoes, isn't it? In that way, if we see, so many people like mangoes and we have to supply mangoes to so many people. So, in that way, you imagine how many trees we require for mangoes. So, in that way, we are talking about only one fruit here, only mango. In that way, we have so many fruits, isn't it? On this earth, we find so many fruits. So, not only fruits, we require vegetables also. In that way, we get number of vegetables. Not only that, in addition, we also require our staple diet. What is that? Rice. Mostly we eat rice in our lunch and dinner like that, isn't it? So, for this, to produce these things of the same kind, producing lots and lots of things of the same kind is called as reproduction or producing new thing. So, producing the fruit or vegetables of the same kind is for reproduction, and today's lesson is reproduction of plants or growing of plants. So, how do we grow plants? Plants are grown in different ways. Plants are grown by seeds, by the other parts of the plants like roots, leaves, stem. Roots, leaves, stems, etc. So, mostly we get plants from seeds, isn't it? We get plants from seeds. Where do we find seeds? We find seed inside a fruit. So, seeds are required to grow. So, let us learn the structure of a seed. When we know that we get plants from the seeds, we have to know the structure of a seed. I will show you one seed. You have to identify what seed it is. Now, see this one. What is this seed? Yes, very good. It is a mango seed. Isn't it? So now, when you see this seed, you will observe some parts on it. Now, what is this? The outer covering. So, the outer covering of a seed is called a seed coat. Isn't it? So, this seed coat will protect the seed inside. And inside this seed coat, you will have a small baby plant called as embryo. Inside this seed, you have a small baby plant and two cotyledons will be there, or seedlings. And these seedlings supply plant to the, supply food to the plant or the seed. So see this seed. So seed has parts like seed coat. Cotyledons, and a baby plant inside it. Now, you must know the structure of a seed. Now, what is the structure of a seed? So, these are the parts that the seed has. I'll show you. After splitting a seed into two parts, how do you get two parts? So this is a kidney bean seed. You see this one. This is also called as rajma seed. Now see this seed will split into two, isn't it? So if a seed splits into two like this, it is called, said to be a dipod seed. It is said to be a dipod seed. And single seed like rice or wheat is a monopod seed. So, you see like this. This is the seed coat, outer covering. This is the seed coat. This is the seed coat. These two parts are cotyledons. And you have a small baby plant inside, a seedling or a baby plant like this. So, all seeds do not grow into plants. Some seeds are destroyed by heavy rains. Some seeds are destroyed by wind. Some seeds are destroyed by weeds. Some seeds do not get sufficient sunlight. Sufficient sunlight, air and water. So, some seeds, they do not get sufficient sunlight, air and water. So, they cannot grow into a new plant. So, they cannot grow into a new plant. So, if a seed gets everything, sufficient amount of air, water and sunlight, then it grows into a new plant, and that process is known as germination. So, what is germination? When a seed gets sufficient amount of air, water and warmth, when a seed gets sufficient amount of air, water and sunlight, it grows into a new plant. So when a seed gets sufficient amount of air, water and sunlight, it grows into a new plant. And that process is known as germination. And that process is known as germination. So what is germination, children? So the process of a seed developing into a new plant is called as germination. So when a seed gets sufficient amount of air, water and sunlight, it grows into a new plant or it develops into a new plant, and that process is known as germination. Now this process of germination doesn't take place in one stage, it takes step by step. Now what are the different stages of germination you have to know here? You have to know the different stages of germination. So now what are the different stages of germination here? First of all, if you sow a seed in the soil, this is soil suppose, it is in the soil. It develops a small shoot system which goes up like this. After few days, again it develops a root system also which grows into the soil, and the shoot system grows above the soil. So these are the various steps in the germination of a seed. First you are sowing a seed, then a small shoot system comes up which grows upwards like this. After few days you will observe a small root system which goes into the soil, and the shoot system grows up like this. After few days again you will see a little bit bigger plant like this, and the last stage you will see a whole plant developing like this with the cotyledons. So when this is growing, these are the cotyledons that supply food to this plant. Once this plant develops leaves, it will prepare its own food by the process known as photosynthesis. So when it starts preparing its own food, this cotyledons dry and fall down. So these are the various stages in the germination of a seed. Isn't it? Did you all understand from the beginning structure of the seed? Then I came with the process of germination. Then the stages of germination were explained. So structure of the seed, what do you know about it? That it is having a seed coat. It will protect the baby plant inside. And it has two cotyledons that supply food. So that is the structure of the seed. And moreover, it will have a small hole which will allow the water to get in. In that way, if you soak a seed, it grows into a bigger in size, isn't it? So next is the process of germination. So germination process, I will show you here another seed having a small shoot system. Now see this one. See this seed, all of you? It is having a small sprout, isn't it? That sprout is the shoot system. That sprout is the shoot system. Have you any time eaten green sprouts? Green gram sprouts. Tinnara padina? Molakalu. Have you eaten? So that is the shoot system of this seed. Do you understand? So in that way, a seed will develop into a new plant. Next. Now, coming to the next part, after stages of germination, the next part here is dispersal of the seeds. Dispersal of seeds. Now, what do you mean by dispersal of the seeds? Carrying away of the seeds from the mother plant is known as dispersal. Why is dispersal of seed very necessary? Dispersal of the seeds is required because if so many seeds fall down at one place, what happens? They will not get sufficient requirement of air, water and warmth. In that way, all the seeds cannot grow into new plants. So there is a need for the dispersal of the seeds. Now to disperse these seeds, there are many agents like eggs or wind. So what is dispersal of seeds? Dispersal of seeds means scattering of the seeds from the mother plant, or the seeds moving away from the mother plant is known as dispersal of the seeds. If all the seeds fall down at one place, it gets congested and they will not have enough of light, sunlight, or the food from the soil. They will not be able to get the nutrients from the soil, and they cannot develop into a new plant. So they have to be dispersed from the parent plant. So in that way, there are many agents that help in the dispersal of seeds. So the agents that help for the dispersal of seed are water, wind, animals, and by explosion. So these seeds get scattered away from the mother plant through these agents. Now let us see the dispersal of a seed from by wind or by water. Let us learn it. Dispersal of the seed by wind. Now, what happens here is some seeds have hairy structures or wing-like structures. Some seeds have hairy structures or wing-like structures on them. So these allow them to float in the air. So all these, they have hairy structures or wing-like structures which allow them to float in the air. So they will be floating in the air. Example for that is cotton, cotton seed, and madar seeds. So they have some hairy structure. If this is the seed, it will be having some hairy structures on it. Dandelion. Example are cotton and madar and dandelion also. So they have hairy structures. Sometimes you see, no, in the classrooms, if a seed come floating like that, what you will do? You all scream and shout and look at that seed as if something has entered. That is nothing but a seed which is having some hairy structures and it's floating in the air. So those type of seeds which have hairy structures on them, they float in the air and they move forward, and whenever they get favorable conditions, they drop down and again develop into a new plant. So that is dispersal of seed by wind. So did you understand? Dispersal of seeds takes place through air, water, through animals, and through explosion. So the first one what you have learned is dispersal of a seed by wind. So some seeds have hairy structures or wing-like structures, and they will be floating in the air. When these float, they move away from the parent plant and drop somewhere else, and in unfavorable conditions, they develop into a new plant. So now, dispersal of a seed by wind. Still some more agents are there that help in the dispersal of a seed. Thus, we will continue in our next class. For today, what you have to do here is what I have told you. I have given you the structure of the seed. I have given you different stages of germination of the seed. I have explained you what is germination, what are the agents that help in the dispersal of the seeds, and I have explained you about only dispersal of seed only by wind. The remaining all we will do in the next lesson and you repeat this video, see this video again and again, and you draw the structure of the seed and stages of germination of a seed. Stages of germination of a seed you draw in your book. That is the homework for you. That is the task. You practice it in your homework books. That the homework books you have kept for English, same book you have to do this also, because you have to maintain only one book and you have to do all your homeworks in the same book. So for today's homework of science is stages of germination of seed. Draw the diagram, all of you. Till then, bye. See you in the next session.